Good morning, dear students. In the last class, we have discussed about the trends in the modern periodic table, that is the valency and atomic size. Okay, we have discussed about the valency and atomic size. What happened atomic size in the groups and periods? Atomic size will be increase in the groups and decrease in the periods. Reasons also we have discussed. Now today I am going to discuss about the metallic and non-metallic properties. Metallic and non-metallic properties. This is a small topic. Okay, in periodic classifications, remaining only metallic and non-metallic properties is there. Metallic and non-metallic properties. Non-metallic properties. In the foundation classes also, about the periodic classifications, we are discussed. Already you know the about the metallic and non-metallic properties. But simply I will give the once again, simply I will explain once again. Okay, so metallic and non-metallic properties in the groups and periods. By the activity we have to understand the metallic properties and non-metallic properties of the elements. So examine elements of the third period and classify them into metals and non-metals. For suppose we have to take the any third period or second period elements, fourth period elements, and classify into the metals and non-metals. On which side of the periodic table do you find the metals, and which side of the periodic table we can find the non-metals? Generally, periodic table having the three portions: left side portion, middle portion, and right side portion. Okay, on which side of the periodic table do you find the metals? Metals are which side? Left hand side metals is there. Already we know first A group elements and second A group elements, strong metals. Okay, alkali metals and alkali earth metals, first A group and second A group. Okay, and which side of the periodic table do you find the non-metals? Right side. Right side of the periodic table is the non-metals is there. As we can see, the metals like sodium, magnesium are towards the left hand side. Once you have to observe in the periodic table, sodium and magnesium, which side is there? Towards the left hand side of the periodic table. While the non-metal like sulfur and chlorine are found on the right side, right hand side, in the middle. We have in the middle, we have right hand side. In the middle, we have silicon, which is classified as a semi-metals. In the middle, we have silicon, which is classified as a semi-metals or metalloid, because it exhibits the some properties of metals and some properties of non-metals. Okay, so based on that, we have to understand the left side metals is there and right side the non-metals is there. Okay, left side is the metals and right side is the metals. In the middle, we have silicon, which is classified as a semi-metal or metalloid. What is a metalloid? How can we define the metalloids? The metalloids are exhibit the both the properties of metals and non-metals. These are called metalloids. In the modern periodic table, a zigzag line separates the metals from non-metals. Once you have to observe the modern periodic table, in that zigzag line is there. That line separates the metals from non-metals. The borderline elements boron, silicon, germanium, arsenic, antimony, tellurium, and polonium are intermediate. Okay, so they are having the intermediate properties and are called metalloids or semi-metals. Now metals are which side is there? Metals are, what is the metals? Metals are like sodium and magnesium. Sodium and magnesium are towards which side? Towards the left hand side. Left hand side of the periodic table. So metals are left hand side. What about the non-metals? Non-metals are like sulfur, and chlorine, these are found in right hand side. right hand side of the periodic table towards right hand side of the periodic table right hand side of the periodic table okay so metals are left hand side left portion having the metals and right portion having the non metals we can found the non metals on right hand side of the periodic table okay what about the in the middle we have silicon which is classified as a semi metal or metalloids in the middle metalloids is there in the middle we have metalloids or semi metals we can call semi metals also metalloids are in the middle we have metalloids or semi metals so what is the metalloids how can we define this metalloids or semi metals metalloids so in the modern periodic table a zigzag line separates the metals from non metals the borderline elements boron silicon germanium arsenic antimony tellurium and polonium are intermediate in properties and are called metalloids or semi metals okay what is the metalloids the elements which exhibit the elements which exhibit the properties of metals and non-metals the elements which exhibits the properties of metals and non-metals these elements are called metalloids or semi-metals metalloids these elements are called metalloids okay or semi-metals also we can call okay that means these properties are intermediate in properties okay what are the metalloids is there metalloids like boron silicon germanium arsenic antimony tellurium polonium okay tellurium and polonium these are the borderline elements we can call the metalloids are another name is the semi-metals metalloids are semi-metals why because these are having the intermediate properties okay and we know metals tend to lose electrons while forming bonds that is they are electropositive in nature generally metals are electropositive nature what is the electropositive how can we define the electropositive the tendency of the lose the electrons that is called electropositive okay metals shows the electropositive natures generally metals are highly electropositive nature means they will lose the electrons easily that nature is called electropositive nature okay by the activity we have to understand the electropositive nature and electronegativity nature in the groups and periods okay and now we know the metals tend to lose electrons while forming the bonds that is they are electro positive in nature. Electro positive in nature. That is, they are electro positive in nature. By the activity, we have to understand the about the electro positive nature in the groups and periods. Okay, what happened electro positive nature in the groups? From the top to bottom, what happened? Size will be increased. If size will be increased, means nucleus attraction forces on valency electron will be decreased. So it will be lost the electron easily. Then what happened? Electro positive nature will be increases. Electro positive nature increases means metallic character also will be increases. Electro positive nature and metallic character both are directly proportional. Electro positive nature and metallic character. If electrons losing capacity is increases from the top to bottom in the group, means it will be increase the metallic character. Okay, that is the electro positive nature. So in the groups, what happened? Electro positive nature or metallic character, both are same. The tendency of loose electrons increases in the group and decreases in the period. Okay, because of size, it is depends on the size. Size increases means nucleus charge on the valency electrons will be decreased. Size decrease means what happened? Nucleus charge on valency electron will be increases. So it holds electrons very strong. That's why that electrons not lost in the small atoms. So that is the reason. Now, what happened? Electropositive nature in the groups. Losing electron capacity will be increase in the group. Electropositive nature. Electropositive nature increases in group, and electropositive nature increases in group and decreases in periods. Okay, electropositive nature increases in group and decreases in periods. Then what happened the metallic character? Then metallic character increase in group and decrease in period. Metallic character increase in group and decrease in period. Okay, next one, non-metallic. What about the non-metals? The tendency to gain electrons and change it as you go from left to right and group. That means left to right means period and group. Okay, so what happened? The tendency to gain electron, that is the electronegativity nature. Electronegativity means the tendency of gaining the electrons, that is called electronegativity nature. The tendency of the lose the electrons means that is a electropositive nature. Okay, electronegative nature, what happened in the group and period? By the activity we have to understand. Okay, as the trends in the electronegativity shows, non-metals are found on right side of the periodic table. Okay, if we go the left to right, that is a period. In the period, electronegativity nature will be increased, and in the group, electronegativity nature will be decreased. Electronegativity. Electronegativity. So what is the electronegativity? The tendency to gain electron is known as electronegativity. Tendency to gain electron. The tendency to gain electron is known as electronegativity. En. The tendency to gain the electron is known as electronegativity. En. En means electronegativity. Okay. What happened is electronegativity. So electronegativity increases means non-metallic character will be increases. Okay, electronegativity increases means non-metallic character will be increases. electronegativity increases in periods and decreases in groups. Can you tell the reason electronegativity increases in periods and decreases in the group? Why? Because in the group size, from the top to bottom, size increases, then where nucleus attraction forces on valence electrons will be decreased. That's why electronegativity in nature will be decreased. If you, for suppose, nucleus attraction force on valence electron is strong is there, means that electron will be not lost. It will be accept the electron, it will be gain the electron. So size is small is there means that atom will be attract the electrons. It will be gain the electrons. So in the period size is small and in the group top to bottom size will be increased. So that is the reason electronegativity increases in period and decreases in the group. What happened non-metallic character? Non-metallic character increases in left to right and decreases top to bottom. That means increases in periods and decreases in groups. Non-metallic character increases in periods and decreases in groups So this electronegativity is helped to us by the understanding the metal oxides and non-metal oxides, which nature based on the already we know the about the metal oxides and non-metal oxides. Metal oxides having which nature? Metal oxides are basic in nature. And non-metal oxides are acidic in nature. So metal oxides are basic in nature and non-metal oxides are acidic in nature. Already we know this one. So this is about the trends in the modern periodic table. So according to CBSE, this year portion completed. That carbon and its compounds is there. So that is a deleted topic. Okay, if we have time means after that I will discuss about that chapter. But according to CBSE, now we are finished our syllabus. Okay, thank you all of you.